A cure for cancer has been found. Yeah, this is huge. A study done by researchers at the Stanford University School of Medicine has shown that by injecting a small amount of two immune-stimulating agents directly into a solid tumor in mice can eliminate all traces of cancer in the animal. They have found that this approach works for many different types of cancer. The researchers are hoping the local application of very small amounts of the agent could serve as rapid and inexpensive cancer therapy. It's also unlikely to cause side effects, which is currently unheard of. Professor of Oncology Dr. Ronald Levy is a pioneer in the field of cancer immunotherapy, and he had this to say. When we use these two agents together, we see the elimination of tumors all over the body. This approach bypasses the need to identify tumor-specific immune targets and doesn't require wholesale activation of the immune system or customization of a patient's immune cells. Also, one of the agents is currently already approved for use in humans. A clinical trial was launched in January to test the effects of the treatment on patients with lymphoma. Levy goes on to say, all these immunotherapy advances are changing medical practice. Our approach uses a one-time application of a very small amount of two agents to stimulate the immune cells only within the tumor itself. In the mice, we saw amazing body-wide effects, including the elimination of tumors all over the animal. Levy's method works to reactivate the cancer-specific T cells. Some of these tumor-specific activated T cells then leave the original tumor and find and destroy other identical tumors throughout the body. This research has been supported by the National Institutes of Health and the Leukemia and Lymphoma Society, as well as Stanford's Department of Medicine. It's crazy to think that scientists, researchers, and doctors have been looking for a cure for cancer for years now, and the day is finally here. It's truly incredible. Hey everyone, welcome back to LP, I'm Court McGinley. I hope all of you are having a wonderful weekend so far. Let me know what you've been getting up to down in those comments. Toronto has been getting hit with extremely cold temperatures, so yeah, that's what I'm dealing with. One more thing before we get started. We're going to bring questions back for next week. I've had a few people ask me about them, so here they are. All you have to do is post your questions down in the comment section. It could be about something related to working in YouTube, or if you want to know something on a more personal level, you can ask those questions too. I'll be picking a few of the questions and answering them next week. All right, now as you guys know, we have a lot of interesting news stories headed your way, so without further ado, let's get started. Next, it's finally happened. Larry Nassar has been attacked in the courtroom. I knew it was only a matter of time. Randall Margraves is the father of not one, but three of Nassar's victims. He got so enraged during his hearing after the judge denied his request to be permitted 5 minutes alone in a locked room with the predator that he literally lunged at the former Team USA doctor. Luckily for Nassar, officers were there, otherwise I think he would have gotten destroyed. It literally took three officers to hold this enraged father down. Not only did Nassar sexually assault hundreds of girls and young women, many of them Olympians, he was also sentenced to 60 additional years for possession of child pornography. Honestly, Nassar is a really sick man, and it's a known fact that prisoners don't take too kindly to pedophiles. So who knows what's going to happen to him once he's behind bars. Next, Logan Paul almost died. So yeah, this hasn't really been a good year for Logan, has it? First, the whole world hated him after he posted an extremely insensitive video that caused him to receive death threats and people telling him to go kill himself. And now he literally had a brush with death. Logan posted the aftermath of this event to his Instagram story. He said that he just escaped death as he went skydiving and his parachute didn't open. I swear this is like everyone's nightmare. He posted this picture to Twitter and titled it, "Here is a photo of my empty pack after I had to cut away my main parachute because it didn't open. I can tell you, the feeling of the blue reserve parachute opening and functioning properly was miraculous. This has never happened to another student before at this school. LP lives on." On Logan's Insta story, he also said that he has the footage from this experience and he will be uploading a vlog about it soon. Luckily, he's okay. Next, the groundhog has seen his shadow and we officially have 6 more weeks of winter. No! So for those of you who don't know, yesterday was Groundhog Day. It's a 132-year-old tradition. Every February 2nd, we wait to see if the little groundhog is going to scurry out of his hole. The idea is the groundhog wakes up from hibernation on the 2nd. And if it sees its shadow, there will be 6 more weeks of winter. And if it doesn't, then warmer weather is right around the corner. So you better keep out those hats, mittens, and scarves, folks. This colder weather is just going to keep on coming. Next, Venice canals have completely dried up. Thanks to cold wintry weather, low tides, and little rain, the iconic, not to mention the city's vital waterways, have dried up. This is actually the 3rd year in a row that this strange phenomenon has struck Venice. For example, 2 years ago, the water levels fell as much as 28 inches below normal levels. And then on the other hand, the city faces flooding several times a year as well. Seeing as the city is slowly sinking, residents are finding living there increasingly difficult. But on the topic at hand, sorry to say, but if you have a trip to Venice planned anytime soon, there aren't going to be any beautiful canals to look at. Next, Tom Cruise is leaving Scientology. This is extremely shocking, especially since he's been a devoted member of the church since he joined in 1990. He's allegedly leaving the church so he can mend his relationship with his daughter, Suri Cruise. A source close to the family revealed that he wants his daughter back and he's going to have to walk away from the church in order to do that. Leaving Scientology would be the toughest decision he'll ever have to make. Tom has been made aware that the church would do everything in its power to keep him from leaving. It's also been reported that Tom might try to cut a deal with the church by promising not to speak out against Scientology in return for his departure from the organization. Last time Tom Cruise was seen with his daughter was in 2012. So yeah, it's been a while. Tom's ex and mother of Suri, Katie Holmes, doesn't have high hopes that Tom will leave the church to spend time with his daughter. So I guess we'll just have to wait and see. Next, 95-year-old Marvel legend Stan Lee has been rushed to the hospital after falling ill at home. After being seen by doctors, Lee is stable, but he's still at the hospital receiving precautionary treatment. About this, Stan said, "All I really want to tell you is that I'm feeling great. I'm glad I spent that evening at the hospital. It did me a lot of good." The next movie he's set to make his cameo in is Black Panther, which is actually expected to be the best Marvel movie yet. So we'll have to wait and see about that. I'm sure it's not going to disappoint. Hopefully Stan Lee makes a speedy recovery. But honestly, the fact that he's 95 and is doing so well and he's aware and healthy is amazing. Next, Google joins the $100 billion club. Google posted its first $100 billion year. That's actually insane when you think about it. It was reported on Thursday that Google topped $100 billion in annual sales for its first time in Google's 20-year history. It's posted $32.3 billion in sales for the fourth quarter, pushing its total annual revenue to $110 billion. That's up from about $90 billion in 2016. This milestone is a testament to the strength of Google's ad sales business, which continues to grow rapidly even though the company faces controversies over Russian bot election ads and offensive videos on YouTube. Congratulations to Google on this huge success. Alright, and there you guys have it. That's all the news stories I have for you today. Thank you all so much for watching. Don't forget to leave those questions down below and I'll catch you guys in the next one.